In this video, I'll do a review and walkthrough of Playable. I'll take you inside Playable and give you a quick demo of how it works. We'll talk about the pricing and we'll go over my pros and cons. Then I'll give you my personal opinion on this product. Lastly, if you stick with me through this entire video, I'll show you how you can get Playable for a one-time price. So let's dive right in. If this is your first time here, click that subscribe button and ring the bell so you don't miss out on content like this. And don't forget to check out my number one strategy for helping you drive organic traffic so that you can build your email list. Simply click on the link below to check out my review. All right, so what is Playable? Well, Playable is a cloud-based software that claims it will help to enhance your email campaigns by allowing you to embed high-quality autoplay videos that are compatible with most email inboxes. Now, why should you even consider using Playable? Well, if you're looking to increase engagement, click-through rates, and ultimately revenue, then this might be the solution for you. Playable published a white paper on video email dwell time, and in this report, they measured how long viewers were watching video emails. This is basically what they found. 80% of engaged viewers watch for 12 seconds or more, and half of all engaged email recipients will watch a video email for 22 seconds or more, or at least 2 to 4 loops of a Playable video. Now, I'll leave a link down in the description below to this white paper so you can see it for yourself. Now let's hop inside Playable so that I can show you how to create a video email. All right, so when you first log into your Playable account, this is what you're gonna see. This is the dashboard. Now you can get started by adding a video or you can continue working on a project. And also Playable will give you some suggested videos that you can use in your email campaigns. Now on the left side, the menu options are very simple. You have my account, your videos, as well as your profile. So this is very self-explanatory, but we're going to take a look at the My Account menu option here. And this is where you can edit your profile or your account details. You can add users. You can change your pricing plan. You can also check out your billing statements. And this last option right here, which is reports, this is where you're able to check out the statistics for your campaigns. Now you can break them down individually as well. But in this case, this one right here is going to give you an overview of everything that you've done. Okay. And as you can see right here, the options are pretty much wide open here. I mean, you can go everything from OS to OS version to the dwell time to day parts and time of days, day of week, even the language. Okay. So this is, gets very, very detailed. Okay. Now we're going to go back here to the main dashboard area. And the first step you're going to do is you're going to either add a video here or you can go into your video. So let's click on this. And as you can see, I've been doing some testing right here with Playable and I'm going to show you how to get started. So first of all you have to do is click on add video. So your first step would be to enter your video title here, or you can allow Playable to auto populate that title based off of your video file. Okay. Down here is the output settings. I'm going to leave everything by default, but you can change this if you want. You can even disable the looping feature for your video email. Now for the source video, you have three options. You can upload a file from your computer. You can choose a URL, or you can also get something from their stock library. So if you're going to go with the URL, which is probably the most standard way to do it, you can choose from YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, TikTok, Vimeo, okay, as well as others. Now, if you have a video hosting service that is atypical, okay, something that's not part of that whole known brandable names, then I would still urge you to try it, because even though I tried one that was a video hosting service that wasn't supported, when I opened up a ticket with Playable, they were able to provide me with a workaround pretty quick, okay? And it worked very, very well. So keep that in mind, okay? If you upload a file from your computer, try and keep that file to about 10 seconds, okay? And the reason why is you want to edit it down is that when people open up your video email, they're going to spend about 8 to 10 seconds anyway just looking at that video file, okay? And you want to be able to present the best possible scenes in order to get them to click on that image and take them to your landing page or wherever it is that you want to take them. Okay. And for the stock library selection here, they are connected with Shutterstock, iStock, a bunch of different stock video services. And when you click on any of these, what you're going to find is that they cost something. Okay. Like they're $25. So unless you're in a pinch or in a bind, I suggest, you know, you use your own stock footage, and most people will anyway. Okay. They'll use their own video footage. So in this case, I'm going to use a URL. I pulled something from YouTube. So I'm just going to enter in the URL here and I'm going to click on apply. Okay, and you can see right here, it auto-populated the title of the video. This is the video that I pulled from YouTube. And while it is processing the video, this box right here is where you can enter in the URL. So this is where they're going to be redirected when they click on your video email file. Okay, so when they open up the video email and they see that video playing, when they click on it, it's going to take them somewhere. Okay, so you can determine where you want them to go. So in this case, I'm going to send people to my landing page, okay? And I'm gonna save that. So now it's been saved. And we're gonna wait while they are formatting this video for us. Okay, now you can see this is what the output looks like right here. The duration is gonna be 10 seconds. Here's all the output dimensions and everything right there. And you can see here is the playable. There's a watermark that shows up at the end, okay? Now, if you want to get rid of that watermark, then you need to upgrade to a different plan in order to remove that. For me, I don't think it's that much of a problem anyway. It's not that obtrusive, so I'm just going to leave it as is. So as you can see right here, these are the different steps that we've gone through. Now, all we have to do is embed. So we're going to click on this selection right here. And as you can see, you can choose from a ton of different email service providers, okay? I use GetResponse, so I'm just gonna keep it as is. And all you're gonna do is you're gonna just copy this code from Playable and you're gonna embed this into your email that you send out, okay? So you're not embedding a raw file into your email, okay? You're gonna be embedding some code. And there's a difference because what this is gonna do is that it's not gonna impact the deliverability of your email, okay? Because when the email is opened, because you have put code in there, when the email is opened, the video code will request the video to be delivered by the Playable servers. And that's also how the best version of that email can be delivered to each individual, depending on their email app, their device, the screen resolution, and network connection. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're just going to copy this to our clipboard, and then we're going to head over to my GetResponse account. I've already opened up a sample newsletter, and this is what we're going to send, okay? Now, all you need to do is, depending on your email service provider, all you're gonna do is just drop a custom HTML block. And again, depending on which one you have, you're gonna have to figure that out. But for GetResponse, is pretty much just dropping this custom HTML block, and I'm just gonna paste in the code. And what's gonna happen is Playable is gonna grab that information, and it's going to populate your email here. Okay, so you can see this is the video. There's a little bit of a branding element, but to me, that's not big of a deal. I don't think it's too obtrusive. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna leave this as is, and we're gonna send a test message, okay? So I'm gonna send a test message to myself so that we can see what this looks like. And here is the test message. Let's go ahead and open it up and see what it looks like. I'm gonna display the messages or the images in this email. And as you can see, Playable goes back to the server, and based off of my email inbox and the technology that I'm using, it's going to serve up the best possible video image. Okay. Now, the majority of recipients are going to get high quality MP4 or HEVC videos. Okay. Others are going to get animated WEBP or PNG, and some are going to get a GIF because that's the best that some email apps can display. So Playable will optimize the frame rates, the resolution, and compression for optimal audience engagement. And one other thing, when you click on the Playable video, it's gonna redirect you to my landing page. So let's go ahead and head back to Playable to check out our statistics. So when we head over here, you can see right here, we've got one unique open and one billable play, okay? And that's how you can pretty much tell how your campaign is doing. Of course, you can always go into your account, head over to reports, and then now you can see kind of like what's been happening with some of your email campaigns or your campaigns that you've done. Now, the tough part here is that this gives you a general sense of how you're doing. It doesn't give you a more specific reporting method, okay? And what will happen is if I want to get more of a specific result, or I want to get more in depth with my results, all I'm going to do is I click on this link, and I need to really pay for another plan here. Okay, so this is, unfortunately, this is a downside. So I would have to upgrade so that I can get more terms in terms of more reporting. Okay, let's talk about Playable's pricing plans. Now, first of all, they have a 30-day free trial, and that includes 1,000 plays and adds a powered by Playable branding element to your videos. Now, if you want to remove that branding or you need more video plays, then you're going to want to upgrade to one of their paid pricing options, okay? They've got a pricing calculator down here. You can see the different options, and you can either pay monthly, or if you pay annually, you can see that the prices drop by about 21%, okay? Now, how many plays do you need? How do you know what's the right plan for you? Well, they do have a calculator here that you can access, and based off of your list size, how many campaigns you want to run per month, and what your predicted open rate is going to be, this will tell you basically which plan that you should go for. So let's say you have a list of just 500, and maybe you want to just do two of these campaigns per month at 20%, which is a good open rate, okay? That equals about 200 opens, which is about 300 plays. And on the annual plan, that would be about $18 per month on the pay-as-you-go annual plan. Now, if you pay it monthly, you're looking at $19 per month. So in this case, obviously, paying the annual price for the pay-as-you-go would probably suit you best. And of course, you can adjust as you need to. And Playable's customer support has been really good. So, you know, they can probably help you out in terms of finding the right pricing option for you. Now, as I had mentioned, there is a AppSumo lifetime deal that is available right now. And with any AppSumo lifetime deal, these things don't last forever, right? So if you're able to take advantage of this AppSumo Playable lifetime deal, it starts at $49. You can go ahead and check what features are available in this deal, as well as stacking up to three codes, okay? So you'll see the single, double, and multiple code options, and you're gonna see the applicable amount of users, videos per month, plays per month. Now, the Playable branding is still gonna be there. When you go, even when you go with the multiple code option, and this just gets a little lighter. If you want to totally get rid of the branding, then when you are in your Playable dashboard, you can go ahead and check out your subscription. And beneath that, they're gonna have some discounted options that are available for people who took advantage of this AppSumo lifetime deal. So it's still a really great deal if you don't really care about the branding. You can still go with that. It's not very obtrusive, and I'm totally fine with it. So I'm just gonna stick with my lifetime deal, and I won't really be upgrading to a paid option. Now let's go over my pros and cons. First, the pros. Playable is easy to use. Now, it takes 5 steps to create a Playable video email, and this is quite a departure from the usual push button 123 software that I review on a regular basis. Now, it works, okay? Playable works, and it supports a wide range of ESPs as well as email clients. Now, videos are hosted and delivered by Amazon, so Playable is built on a solid infrastructure. Customer support is excellent, and there's an AppSumo lifetime deal available. And now the cons. The branding, okay, that's a problem, but I understand the business decision that they made, especially for the AppSumo lifetime deal. They've got to pay for their support and their infrastructure, so therefore I understand why they are putting that watermark there. Now the amount of plays can go fast if you don't get the proper plan. So you'll have to see how your campaigns go before you decide to upgrade to a higher plan. But I guess in the end, that's a good thing. Now the main question is, should you buy this? And my answer is yes and no. So let me explain here. If you're a beginner and you have no list, then obviously Playable is not for you. Your money is better spent investing in a strategy and tools to help you drive traffic so that you can build your email list. Now, if that sounds like you, I've got the perfect product for you. Simply click on a link below to check out my review and to get started. Now, it's a yes if you have a list and you're looking to get better engagement and click-through rates. Playable is worth a try. It's affordable, there's no long-term contract, and the support is excellent. And if you take advantage of the AppSumo deal, then you can save even more money. You're also backed by AppSumo's 60-day, no questions asked money-back guarantee. What's important to keep in mind, though, is that if your list doesn't open up your emails in the first place, then Playable will not help you. It will not help with open rates. It is designed to help build better engagement and increase click-through rates. Therefore, you'd be better off working on improving your email marketing skills. So you're probably asking, will it work? Will it help increase engagement, CTRs, and ultimately increase my bottom line? Well, you won't know until you try it, and that's the rub. As for me, I purchased the AppSumo lifetime deal so that I could do this review, and I'm planning to test out Playable to see if it works. So if you're on my email list, watch out. Video emails are coming your way. So there you have it, my review and walkthrough of Playable. What did you think? Are you going to give Playable a try? Let me know by dropping your comment down below. I'd love to hear from you. Lastly, if you're looking for a proven strategy to drive targeted organic traffic in order to build your email list, then click on the link below to check out my review. This is Ken Furukawa from kenfurukawa.com, and I'll see you in my next video.